Hello again. So how long you want to live? Last time we talked about who has lived longest so far as a human being. Madame Jean Calment, a French lady who lived 122 years, 5 months and 14 days. Now, do you want to live as long or more? Can science help you? Can pills help you? Can genes help you? Now, this is very, very important issue to take into consideration. That so far, we have achieved that. Although nature has made us only for about 45 years. And it's a great success of human beings that we have doubled up the lifespan or tripled the lifespan. And very important part in this understanding of aging from scientific point of view is that whatever life we live, it is not just determined by our genes. There is no gene in my body which kills me. There is no gerontogene, yeah, the gene which causes aging. Evolution has not made genes to cause problems for us. Evolution has made genes to keep us alive. But it does not need the genes to keep us alive for too long a time than needed by essential lifespan. So that means we have to do something about it after the age of essential lifespan. So first of all, we need to get out of this idea that there is a program in the body which is slowly killing me and which one day will absolutely stop me from living. There is no enemy inside the body. The body is our friend. It is no fun for the body to die. It tries its best to survive as long as possible. The dilemma or the paradox is that body has the living systems, but it still doesn't survive forever because nature hasn't made it perfect. And that is where our own responsibility comes, that what kind of life we want to live and what kind of life we are able to live. Often people ask this, is there a secret of life, long life? Yeah, that's one of the most common questions asked by journalists to elderly people. Oh, madam, what is your secret of life? In my view, that's actually most idiotic question to ask. Because of the kind of answers we get from these elderly people who became 115 or 117, what is your secret of life? One will say, I have never eaten meat in my life. I'm absolute vegetarian. But the other one will say, I love meat. If I have to eat vegetables, I get depressed. One will say, I love physical activity, outdoor life. Other one, I hate outside. I love to sit in front of the sofa and watch. One says, I have never married. Other says, I married 5 times. And this Madame Morano, 117 years ago, 117 years old in November 2016, when she was asked, what is the secret of your long life? And she said, I have been eating 2 raw eggs every day from the age of 10 because doctor had advised her. Now, does that mean we should all start eating raw egg? No. Every individual has his own life story, an own life history, an own life curve. And that is one of the great understandings which came from scientific research, that no 2 people become old in the same way, first of all. Yeah. Not even the monozygotic twins, the ones which have same genetics, even they don't become old exactly in the same way. They are more similar to each other, but not exactly similar. No part in the body becomes old in the same way. My brain is aging at a different rate than my muscle or my immune system or my bones or my sugar controlling system. I am a mixture of so many ages, even at biological level. It will depend upon how my early childhood was. Was I getting certain diseases? Did I get any proper food in early childhood or later on? So every part of my body is becoming old at a different rate. Right now, I can feel, for example, that my muscles are becoming weaker. But my brain doesn't feel like that I'm losing a lot at this age. But my eyesight became weaker already when I was below 30. Yeah? So same thing about the sugar. So within the same body, we have different parts aging at different rates. Even within the same tissue, different cells become old at different rates. Within the cell, different molecules, the DNA, RNA, protein, they become old in this different way and different rates. Now, this is a very, very important part to understand. That if somebody tells you that I have a magic pill, which is going to keep everybody alive or you as a total alive forever and healthier, just one pill for everybody. No, it's not scientifically correct. It may be deliberately a business ploy or whatever, but there is not going to be universal solutions. So if we want to do something about our life, we will have to find our own solutions. We will be sharing with you what are the general principles, what we have learned over the last 50 years of research by hundreds of scientists. What have they reached the conclusion? Then it can be tweaked according to the need of the individual. What we can do and what we cannot do. This has to be understood in a very individualistic manner. Things happen in the body. Nothing much happens towards the better. Continuous growth in the body is not a good sign. Yeah, especially in old age. Continuous growth happens of cancer cells. The normal body has to actually slow down at some stage. So this kind of approach that what we want to do and in which direction our body requires when everything is falling apart, we need to understand what causes it. There is one thing I should definitely like to say here that I have told so many things about bad things happening in the body. That yes, my brain will become weak, my muscles will become weak, my bones, my immune system, everything will become weak. But there is actually something which becomes a little bit better from a social point of view, and that's our brain. The brain of the elderly people, the brain with aging becomes different. It becomes slower, yes, there is a lot of cells are dying in the brain. It cannot take new information easily. It cannot remember many things which are short-term memory easily. But it starts working in a different way. It starts seeing the patterns quickly. The old knowledge combined with the new information, it can make decisions, the synthesis better. And that's what is called experience. The experience part of the brain only comes by living long enough. And that experience tells you how this particular situation is going to unfold. Yeah? Even the elderly drivers in the same area where they have been living actually become better with age because they can see the pattern, the flow of the traffic. At a new place, they will have more difficulty because the new information is difficult. Experience increases with age, and perhaps due to the application of experience, our wisdom increases with age, our empathy, our ability to empathize, because we have lived long life, we can feel how something hurts somebody, how we should be sympathetic. This increases with age. These are some of the positive aspects of old age also, which we need to hang on to and find and make use of that. And that's what we will talk more and more later on, that how the good things which are happening and what is the secret of happening. But remember one thing, which I like to always present, that a Danish philosopher and a doctor, Esther Muller, once said, we are all born as copies, but we die as original, because no two people become old in the same way. We are born in a similar way. So our story of life is actually the story of becoming original, authentic. Let's talk about it more next time. See you then.